Hello, I am immediate past president Lei Quezada of the Rotary Club of Makati Premier District. If you want your membership to grow and increase your donors and sponsors, here are some fundamental tips by simply promoting your club effectively. Before I dive into how to promote your club effectively, please know that doing this is only part of a more holistic approach. After leading our club for a year, I learned three basic ways to build a solid and successful club, which is key to attracting more people to join you and support you. First, nurture your members. Provide opportunities for them to serve and feel good that they are part of a winning team, your Rotary Club. Secondly, organize your club processes with openness and transparency. One of my key learnings is institutionalizing specific processes to strengthen the club's foundation. Actions and decisions become more objective with processes that are well-defined and spelled out. There is less subjectivity and emotion. These processes include new member admission, the club's officers' nomination, the governor's election, and many more. And of course, when in doubt, apply the Rotary's four-way test. And then finally, wow the world. Promote your club. Share your experiences. I learned the importance of promoting our club. Given my background in digital marketing with a Fortune 500 company, I was mindful of the power of telling our stories. I used my experience and Rotary's excellent People of Action materials and guidelines to tell our stories. Stories inspire others to join and support you. Access this video on YouTube to get detailed tips on building a solid club that will attract others to join. An easy link to remember on how to access this video is bit.ly/rcmpd-best. Again, that's bit.ly/rcmpd.best. Today, I want to focus on how you can wow the world to gain membership and supporters. There are three levels of sophistication to promote your club and its activities. If you still need to do something, start at level one. Through time, move up to levels two and three. In level one, use Facebook effectively. In level two, create a club website. This is where you keep evergreen information like your club advocacies, club member profiles, and archives of your newsletters, if you have any. In level three, in addition to social media and website, start creating newsletters that you can email to your list of members, supporters, and donors. Here are a few examples. You can interchange levels two and three of creating a website and sending newsletters. However, both levels require competency, not only to create them, but also to use the tools. They also need club funds to buy the yearly subscription to use the digital tools. If you have neither, focus on making Facebook or Instagram your platform to communicate with the world. The first thing that you must know is that content is king. Make meaningful content. Did you know that the number one reason people join a club is to feel like they belong? So the question to ask yourself is, what makes people feel like they belong? People feel like they belong when everyone has shared values. Share your People of Action images. These are images of your beneficiaries and the differences that you have made. Caption them with Rotary's Together We. Here are a few examples. Together We save lives with free early cancer screening and then show the beneficiary of that service. Together We teach kids dental care so they can smile always. Together We build healthier communities with free medical consultation. Here's an example of a bad post. Try to avoid posting about all the Rotarians or dignitaries that attended instead of showing beneficiaries and how we help them. Remember that Rotary's motto is service above self, not the other way around. Use your club members as your ambassadors. Have your members share their Rotary experience. We ran several series called What Rotary Means to Me and What Gives Me Joy, and then asked our members to answer that question in 30 words or less. Here are a few examples. This one is BP Raisa's What Rotary Means to Me. She said, Rotary was my unique bond with my father, the late past RI director, Paing Echanova. The years I spent project managing his three books on Rotary and having insightful conversations on doing good in the world created a special bond that only he and I had. I miss him. This one is from our PE, Eric Kesson. What gives me joy? Knowing that I have helped or comforted someone and having a good meal with family and friends. And then finally, from our club member, Tony Urusha, what Rotary means to me. During this critical time and uncertain times in history, the Rotary has been an enabler for me in bringing hope to the underserved, letting them know that they are not forgotten, that they are not alone. Readers who relate to your club members' experiences are more inclined to join your club. Doing posters like this also doubles as member engagement, an important ingredient to having a solid club. As a side note, we conducted a medical mission without a medical doctor in our club. We also held a golf tournament with only one golfer at that time in our club. The point is, our invitation to others who share our values was accepted. Doctors and golfers were willing to help in our two events. People want to feel like they belong. Know that words matter. Use this Rotary guideline to tell a story. Answer the questions as you see them in the guideline. You can even concatenate by asking three questions: what, why, and an invitation. Describe what happened, then explain why it matters, and then invite your audience to do something. Here's an example. What? We conducted a health outreach in Lobo, Batangas. Why it matters? We increased awareness of the importance of yearly preventative health checkups. Healthy residents make healthy communities. And then finally, invite them. Be a volunteer in our next health outreach. Now that you know that content is king and quality content matters, the second thing you should know is you could also invite conversations. Ask a question in your post to invite people to write in or do a poll. For example, when you post something like this, ask your readers what gives them joy. Engage people and start a conversation. Frequency matters. Try to post 3 times a week with quality content. You create fans and followers with frequent quality posts. This is similar to when you make friendships and try to make every encounter worthwhile. Facebook makes this easy with tools to create your content calendar ahead of time. Simply go to Meta Business, which is on the left side of your page, and pick the calendar icon. From there, you can queue your post on a calendar. This is a time saver. You could also boost your posts for pay to reach a broader audience. Once you have a follower base, you can do many things with them. You can invite them to support your fundraisers, ask them to volunteer, come to your events and club meetings. Since Facebook is global, you can have international supporters too, including your friends and families overseas. Tag other groups of similar advocacies as yours. Their followers will also see your posts. To tag, simply put the @ and then their group name. Effectively promoting your club makes you more attractive to prospective members, donors, and sponsors. It's like a seal of good housekeeping. I have prefixed my presentation by pointing out that building a solid club is your top priority. Communicating effectively what you do on social media is the icing on the cake. Share your best stories and experiences, and you will expand your influence. People will be attracted to what you do. An old proverb says, "Don't chase the butterflies. Mend your garden and let the butterflies come." So focus on building a solid club and communicate well. The butterflies will come. So what's the outcome? We have religiously done what I shared with you today for 5 years now since I joined the club. What we have seen is an increased sphere of influence. For example, potential new members research what the club is about. Our Facebook page and website increase their confidence that they are joining a solid club. A second example is the Ronald McDonald House. They found us on Facebook and they donated 5,000 toys to us. I asked them how they found us. They replied, "We saw you on Facebook." See, that's where frequency of quality posts matter. A Philippine Banks Foundation also found us this way. They donated school supplies to public schools through us. A third example is about foreign visiting Rotarians. They've come to our club meetings. We asked them how they found us. Here's what they say.
How I found you. I need to say I was Googling Rotary in Manila, and actually I found three clubs. The first one had a non-working website. Mm-hmm. The second one was your club, and it's, by the way, the most attractive and most communicative Rotary website I found. And then I made use of your contact formula and got in contact with these nice ladies here now around me. And I'm very thankful for being your guest today. Looking forward during my next business trip to join one of your meetings in the future again.
Yeah, fantastic. Thank you.
In closing, inspire people with what you do, and in time, you will find them drawn to your club to be members, sponsors, donors, and friends. Start with Facebook. Take the first step, learn, improve, and grow from there. Next time, I will show you the key elements of a good website and how to engage even more with newsletters. I am Leia Quesada, immediate past president of the Rotary Club of Makati Premier District. I wish everyone great success this Rotary year. Let's all continue to inspire others and ignite hope in the world.